Good morning. So good to see all of you today. We're happy to have you here. Happy Resurrection Day to all of you. Good morning. Stand up on our feet if you're ready to celebrate God today and His goodness. And just say, Lord, you are good all the time. Our drummer's ready.
Major fur. All right. Well, are you excited to be in God's house today?
Yes.
Well, we want to open up with a word of prayer. Lord, we thank you for today. We thank you for this Resurrection Sunday, the day we commemorate the completed work of Christ and everything he provided for us through his death, his burial, and most importantly, his resurrection has sealed everything for us and made it all the great blessing available to us through him. Lord, we welcome your Holy Spirit here with us this morning to guide and to direct, to minister, to be our teacher. And Lord, we desire that we'll be hearts open, prepared, and ready to receive everything that you want to pour into us today. We thank you for that in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Shout the voice of praise. Shout.
Well, you can all be seated. We're kind of changing things up a little bit here this morning. And so that really affects me that tries to remember how I changed it all up. But what we want to do right now is take a real quick moment and to welcome any first-time guests we have. If this is your first time here, I just want to say welcome. I'm not going to make you stand up or introduce yourself or confess all your sins to everyone or anything like that, because, well, I'm not here to embarrass you. I'd like you to come back here again. But I do want you to know this, that you are welcome here at our church anytime. Well, because it's not my church, it's God's. And he, as far as I know, you're welcome. Everybody's welcome. And we want you to know that you're welcome to worship with us here anytime. You might ask, what do you guys believe at this church? Well, we believe in the Bible, that it is the Word of God, that it is truth, it is the only real source of truth that we have. And we believe, based on what His Word shows us, that we serve a God who is good all the time, who is faithful to His Word. You know, that we don't necessarily believe that if you're a Christian, everything's just supposed to be perfect and nothing bad ever happens to you. And if anything's going on, maybe there's something wrong with you or anything like that. But we do know this. Jesus said in John 10:10, the enemy comes but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. And Jesus said, but I come that you have life and have life more abundant. And we know that putting Christ at the center of our lives leads to abundance, and He wants abundance in every part of your life. You know, He cares about more than just the church stuff, too. Right? He cares about your home, your family, your health, your finances, your job, every part of your life. If you put Christ at the center of it, He leads you to more abundance in your life. And so we're on a journey together as a church. We're learning and we're growing in those things. We invite you to be part of it with us. If you are new, we actually ask for everyone to fill out one of the connection cards for us. So if you didn't get one of those on your way in, you probably did. But if we missed you somehow, if you put your hand up, the ushers will get one of those to you. If you're new, you can just give us as much information as you're comfortable giving us. The back side of the card is really what's more important to me. And you'll see there's places on there. You can check some boxes off to ask specific questions or to get information about certain things here at the church. But the most important thing to me on that card is the area for prayer requests. And Pastor Tammy and I do pray over each and every one of those. We don't just kind of do a simple put our hands up and go, Lord, bless them. All right, what's next? All right, we do earnestly pray over each one of those each week. We have an intercessory prayer team that prays over them throughout the week. We have teams that get together down here at the church a couple times during the week, too, to pray over the needs of the people in our church. So know that you have people praying for you. You have church family lifting you up. That God's house is to be a house of prayer, and that's what we want it to be. You can turn those cards in as you are leaving service today. The ushers will be at the back doors. You can drop them off with them on your way out. If you happen to miss one of them, you can drop that at the information counter, or I pretty much give it to anybody around here that knows what looks like they know what's going on, and they'll make sure it gets to us if you need it to. And if you are new, I'd love to meet you after service and shake your hand, get to know you a little, and answer any questions that you might have. All right, let's see. The next thing I guess I probably ought to do before I forget about it is to dismiss our youth. If any of our youth are here and want to go to their service, they can do that. And we'll be moving normally we do the offering here, we'll do that to